Hello, I'm Kristen Griffith-Vanderyacht from the Big Flower Fight.
Our resident judge, Kristen Griffith-Vanderyacht.
Time is running out.
This is crazy.
It's going to be a very difficult decision.
And today, I'm going to show you how to make this beautiful arrangement using grocery store flowers. You are going to need a dozen stems of a cream flower. This is a rose. About a dozen stems of a muted blush rose. About 10 stems of lavender. 15 stems of peonies. They had this one random fuchsia one in the package, but I said, I'll take it. And then you're also going to need about 10 stems of seeded eucalyptus. Now, if they don't have peonies and roses and lavender at your grocery store, that is okay. Just focus on color. So the color palette that we're using is a cream with a soft blush and a muted blush and a lavender. It's all very muted, not super vibrant. All right, let's get started. To begin, we are going to prep our vase. The vase that I'm using is this low stone bowl. Just use whatever vessel you want. The great thing about flowers is it's hard to mess it up. We're going to begin by creating a grid over our bowl. And the grid is really great because it allows for you to put stems in and not have them move around as much. What I'm using right now is waterproof tape. You can get it online, you can get it at really any sort of floral supply store. I even think I've seen them at crafting stores. Once you have your grid, you're going to take your tape and you're going to go all the way around your vase. That helps to add some extra security to your grid. So when you're designing, your grid doesn't pop off. And there you have it. That is our tape grid that we're going to use. Let's talk about water. Okay, I like to use either distilled or purified water for my arrangements. And if you don't have, you know, a water filter or a purifier, that's okay. You can just use regular tap water, but leave it out overnight. The reason why I do that is the aerated water that comes out of your faucet, that has a lot of air bubbles. Air bubbles can carry bacteria, and bacteria kills your flowers. And we want this to last for as long as possible. Don't fill it all the way to the top, because as you add in your stems, the water level will rise. To begin, oh, this is always the fun part. Where to start? Where to start? Do I start with the greens? Do I start with the flowers? I think for this arrangement, we're going to begin starting with the greens. The greens we're going to use to help build the shape, sort of the structure of the arrangement. And it's always a good idea to sort of just examine your flowers and the bunches that you have to sort of see which way these stems are moving. Like this guy is very droopy. There's no way that I'm going to get this guy to be upright in an arrangement. So I'm just going to go ahead and honor its shape and put it off to the side. And you're going to want to make sure that any leaves or debris that might go into the water, you pull off of the stem beforehand. I'm just sliding it right into my bowl at an angle. Continue doing that all the way around. Oh, so pretty, so juicy. Starting to look good. As you can see, I still have a few stems of eucalyptus left over. I want to save some for the end in case I need more. I don't want to run out. I think we're going to start with our cream roses. This is sort of our base color. Start by taking one rose and just cut it super, super short. Bam! And you're going to place that right in the middle of your arrangement. It doesn't make sense now, it'll make sense later. And you're going to pepper them throughout your centerpiece. I like to start on the side, after I put one in the center, and then I just do that same mirror image on the other side. So look, as you can see, we've started out, we have flowers sort of going all the way around the arrangement. Now I'm going to go in with my peonies and I'm going to sort of put them on inside of the arrangement because I want to start creating depth and levels in my arrangement. We're staying low right now. We're staying low. We're going to bring height later. Oh my gosh. Huh. I'm gonna save you for later. You're gonna be the star. Okay, so we've got about, you know, 4 peonies in here. We've got about 5 roses in here, and now we're going to bring in some of our more muted tones. A little trick with roses, if they're super tight, is you can just blow in the center and give them a little twist, and that can help them open up a little better. Aha! Bam! Oh, that one was so good! Oh my goodness! I'm telling you, a blow and twist. Blow and twist. You can also just put your hand in and gently, like, you know, take the claw. I'm gonna add in some more roses into a few of the holes that I'm seeing. Ooh, is it time? Is it time for you, dear friend? Hello, I think it's time for you, for your moment. You guys must think I'm crazy, honestly. You must. But I've got news for you. When the camera's not here, I'm still talking to the flowers like this. We're almost there. We're almost there. We're just gonna add a few more stems and continue to build out the shape. A few more peonies, and then we're going to get into our lavender. Don't be afraid to use these little buds, even though they're not open. They will open over time, which just extends your experience and your relationship with your arrangement. I'm gently twisting this as I put it into my arrangement. Makes it easier to guide. There you go. Oh, that's pretty. All right, I feel like we've reached a very good place with our main structure. Now it's time to add the flare, which is going to be our beautiful and fragrant lavender. You can strip off your stems pretty easily by just pinching the stem and pulling down, and it should come off fairly easily. I would always suggest using gloves for this. My hands, however, you know, are pretty much leather bags at this point, so I don't really feel it. And you're just gonna start to go in and place it. Start on one side of the arrangement and then work over to the other side. As you can see, the lavender just really makes this palette feel a lot more rich and have a lot more depth to it. And it smells amazing! As I get to the center of the arrangement, center, I'm actually going to make the lavender a little bit shorter. As you can see, we've sort of created, you know, a valley going down the middle of this arrangement. It's easier for the eye to digest. All right, I think we're almost there. We're just gonna add a few more touches of lavender, give it one final look through, and we will be ready. It can be a little tricky when your arrangement is stuffed with other flowers to put those final stems in, but it's worth it. That little bit of patience, it's definitely worth it. Oh my gosh. Okay, I think we're done. Let me just move this stuff out of the way. I hope you feel inspired to go out to the grocery store or go out to your garden or go wherever there are flowers and get yourself a good bunch or a few dozen and make something beautiful at home. All right, and don't forget, you can watch The Big Flower Fight on Netflix right now. I'm Kristen Griffith-Vanderyacht and I love you. Okay, bye.